Oyster is back with Philly. Coming to the beautiful Del Mar of the Eastern Shore. I'm here at the Eastern Shore Arts Beer Festival. I'm here with Josh from Black Tower Brewing. You know, from about what, 8 months, 9 months?
9 months, yeah. Yep. Babies.
He's got another baby this game?
Yeah, we have a 4-month-old as of tomorrow, 4 months old, so that's been pretty awesome.
Congratulations.
I didn't many babies at one time.
Yeah, until your final law told me, I didn't know that you had a baby.
Yep.
Congratulations. So now you're a big dog family dad.
Oh, yeah.
And you got the brewery.
Yep.
And you got some food on there.
Yep.
How's your food? You got a farm to take?
So the nice thing is, we're in an old horseshoeing house, right? So our property owner still has the seafood market on the lot. So we basically have all of his old oyster beds that have been there for generations. He's doing oyster half shells, steam oysters. He's catching his own blue crabs, steaming those up, does spice shrimp and crab cakes, all sorts of stuff. So we have great
crab cakes, which is really well known.
Right.
Chincoteague oysters, which are world famous.
Yep.
You got that. And here's the good thing. Anybody coming down here to Chincoteague Island, and in the fall, you can hunt on the beach. Pay a fee.
Yep.
If you have a hunter's license, you can hunt on the beach legally.
Yep.
So while you're coming down, you're right around the corner from there, right? On Chicken?
Absolutely. Chicken City Road.
I'm going to take a lesson. Chicken City Road. You're not thinking about this. Chicken truck. Anyway, so Josh, tell me, I've got a couple of your beers. I love the Crummy family that's not here today.
Yes.
How about it, corn lager? What's different about this?
So, how about a corn lager? A, it's one of my favorite phrases on the shore, how about it?
Okay.
Which Chris says way better than I do, by the way. How about it?
How about it?
See? True shoreman says how about it the right way. I'm learning. How about it? I'm getting it. So it's our kind of craft take on an American light lager that a lot of the shore folks would be able to relate to, Bud Light, Miller Light, Coors Light, that sort of thing. Right? So it's in that style. It's 4.2%, nice low ABV, and we utilize, instead of what a lot of times people use, flaked rice or flaked corn, if we're some large producer in the Midwest, we take advantage of the Savage Brothers and Pungo Creek Mills and Painter, their heirloom bloody butcher varietal of corn. It's been grown here since the 1870s. So just a fantastic local ingredient that we get to highlight in a way that kind of makes sense to where we are right now on the shore. So.
Also, you use Seaside Hops and Dixon,
yep,
right?
Exactly. Cockle Creek's got his Nugget just grown here in Montepargo. So we've got another pre-mail we did just this past week that'll be ready next Friday that uses a bunch of his just harvested Zeus hops. So there's some awesome local ingredients. And all of our grain is all Virginia-grown barley, all malted in Virginia as well.
So you get all local ingredients. Use as much as you can locally. The IPA, by the way, is awesome.
Thanks.
If you like Scottish ales, it's really good. How about a corn lager? Try that. And the Crummy family, really good. And by the way, you've got some growlers in the background.
Yeah.
And a really cool thing is, look at the artwork on this. This is the famous lighthouse in Assateague. You got the many waters. You got the salty. This is the salt. Tell me about this. It's kind of unique here.
Yeah, so there's an old German style called Goza.
Right.
It was a tart wheat beer that was naturally briny because the water in the river Goza was salty. So we took that style and reimagined it for the Eastern Shore. Chincoteague, they're called salts. So we figured, why add salt to the beer when we just use what's already great about the island, and we use Chincoteague salt oysters in the beer.
Right.
So there's 2 gallons of oyster flesh and 15 gallons of oyster liquor.
So you actually put, not only do you put the red drink, you put the actual oyster flesh.
Yep.
Awesome.
2 gallons of it. So from Tom's Cove, which is amazing. So yeah, it's just an opportunity to be where we are in a drinkable way, which is a lot of fun.
And you guys have really got real busy this summer.
Yeah.
Assateague's very popular beach. If you get a chance, you come down, you can see the ponies on Assateague, right on the beach. And unlike Maryland side, where they run wild, they're contained. So if you go on the beach to sunbathe, or go surfing, or whatever, they're not around.
There's not as much evidence of horses.
Right.
No, on the beach.
Right. There's videos online. You can look up where people go to feed a horse.
Yeah.
And then wonder why it's coming after them later.
Exactly.
Anyway, but this is awesome. Chance to check these guys. Check them out. Have an awesome. One more quick thing. For the fall, what's coming up new? Any pumpkin ales or like a s'more?
We're actually working on a Märzen, an Oktoberfest right now. We've got a barrel-aged version of our local wild fennel stout working out right now. We actually just were down at Chatham Vineyards yesterday. Harvesting some of their Chardonnay grapes for them. This morning we put them into a wild tart blonde ale, so that'll be a local Chardonnay grape, kind of sour that we're doing. So a lot of fun kind of fall ingredient beers coming up.
Awesome. If you guys want to check them out, I'll put the link to their website on there. What's your address? Chicken City Road?
4522 Chicken City Road, Chincoteague, Virginia.
Chincoteague, Virginia. awesome. Have a great day, guys.